Question number 6. One of the biggest surprises in the former governor's memoirs was the news that he did not seek re-election because he had fallen ill. Now, if you're like me, this sounds funky. It just sounds kind of off, right? We've got all of these plural words. One of the biggest surprises in the former governor's memoirs was the news. It's like, it sounds like if we've got multiple surprises and we've got multiple memoirs, perhaps. So it shouldn't be was. That sounds really funky. This is why our instincts are not what we should be trusting. We shouldn't be just following our instincts. We should be thinking intellectually about what's the subject of this verb and when did it happen. So, one of the biggest surprises in the former governor's memoirs was the news. We're looking for the subject of the word was. What was the news? I don't know. Can we cross out any prepositional phrases or any parenthetical statements? I do see the word of right there, and I do see the word in right there. So anything after of, I've got to cross that out. I see in the former governor's memoirs. I've got to cross that out as well, right? Those are two prepositional phrases. I want to get rid of them. I see here that all I'm left with is one was the news. So the word one, is that singular or plural? That's pretty singular, right? That's about as singular as it can get. One was. Is this correct? Absolutely. Is there anything wrong with this? No. If I want to look at my other answer choices and say, what's wrong with these other answer choices? Well, one were, that's absolutely impossible. That's, again, a plural verb. One are, that's another plural verb. And one have been, that's plural and the wrong tense. And just like pretty much anything that can go wrong has gone wrong with answer choice J. We want to keep no change. There's nothing wrong with it.